Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome to Quick Brick Games, where we cover all the latest in the LEGO video game series created by TT Games. And usually on this channel, we talk about LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga, because that's the big game coming out here in 2020. There's a lot of hype, and there's a lot of excitement around it, about when it's coming out and things like that. But this time, we're going to switch it up a bit and talk about something that's not announced, and that is the next LEGO Indiana Jones game. So there's a possibility this could come out next year, so let's go ahead and get into it. So the last LEGO Indiana Jones game was actually back in 2009, so it was a very long time ago. But let's talk about the history of the LEGO Indiana Jones games for a bit. So the first game came out in 2008. It was called LEGO Indiana Jones The Original Adventures. And I remember playing this back on the PSP back in the day, where that game, if you've played the PSP version, it was the same as the console version, except maybe the graphics were a little bit downgraded. But the load times in that version were insane. So if you played the PSP version, let me know if you remember those insane load times. But anyway, so we had that game back in 2008, and that game was actually hinted at in LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga, which of course I've ranked as the best LEGO Star Wars game before Skywalker Saga. So I think if you played all the bonus levels, there was a trailer for LEGO Indiana Jones, and once you watch the trailer in the Complete Saga game, then you unlock the character. And I think, if I remember correctly, I think the Indiana Jones character played exactly like Han Solo, because they're both Harrison Ford, and they're both under Lucasfilm. And you could play as Indiana Jones in LEGO Star Wars, which was pretty cool. And a lot of people are hoping that they put LEGO Indiana Jones within the Skywalker Saga game, because what if they did a similar thing? I just not thought of this just now. They could, in the Skywalker Saga game, if indeed we are getting an Indiana Jones game next year, what if they just put a LEGO Indiana Jones once again in the Skywalker Saga game, kind of calling back to what they did with the Complete Saga, and they had a trailer or a teaser for the new Indiana Jones game coming out next year? I think that'd be pretty cool. Of course, all that's unconfirmed. We have no idea what's coming after Skywalker Saga from TT Games. But anyway, I just thought I'd mention that. I think it would be a pretty cool Easter egg if we did have a LEGO Indiana Jones in the Skywalker Saga, because a lot of people want him in there. And what if they could literally do the exact same thing again, what they did with Complete Saga? I don't know, just an idea. So we had LEGO Indiana Jones The Original Adventures in 2008, and that covered the original three LEGO Indiana Jones movies, because at the time that was right before The Crystal Skull, the fourth movie, came out, which a lot of people don't like. But that was the original movie, three movies covered in that game, and it had the hub world of Barnett College. And it was a really good game. It followed kind of the same formula as the LEGO Star Wars games, and it was great. And then just a year later, in 2009, we had LEGO Indiana Jones 2, The Adventure Continues, and this is where they implemented that fourth movie, The Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. And it also included the first three movies, which they had just covered the year before. So it was kind of weird, like they're already making a sequel to a game that was like a year ago, and most of the content from that game was already covered in that game that came out a year ago. So it was kind of weird. I don't really understand why they did it like that. But yeah, we had that game in 2009, and I don't think that game was very good. That's probably one of the bottom tier LEGO games in my opinion. I haven't played all of them. I've heard the LEGO Movie game, especially the LEGO Movie 2 game, is pretty bad, which came out, I think, back in like 2018, 2019. I've heard that game's terrible, and I've heard that LEGO Incredibles isn't very good. But Indiana Jones 2, of the ones that I've played, that seems to be one of the worst in my opinion. Maybe some of you guys like it, but I really don't like how they kind of covered the first three movies, then they kind of covered unimportant scenes from those movies at points, and a lot of the times they change things like drastically. Of course, they got to change some things a little bit to fit the LEGO games and the LEGO series, but I think they just changed things a little bit too much and made it kind of goofy in LEGO Indiana Jones 2. I think the first game covered those first three movies a lot better. And also the hub worlds in LEGO Indiana Jones 2 were weird. They were kind of like open world. They definitely tried to change up the formula, because I think at the time, you know, we had LEGO Star Wars 1 and 2, The Complete Saga, then we had Indiana Jones, we had LEGO Batman. At this point, there was a bunch of LEGO games coming out, and I think a lot of people, well, maybe criticizing them for following the same formula over and over again, which they still kind of follow that formula, but I guess it was more prevalent back then. So maybe they tried to switch it up a bit with LEGO Indiana Jones 2, and I don't really think it worked. Like, there's these big open world hub worlds. There's like several, you know, at this point there was usually only one hub world, and then you choose the levels. Whereas here it kind of confused a lot of players, because there wasn't just a simple doorway to go through each level or each movie. Like, you had to explore each of these little hub worlds and discover the levels throughout there. It kind of works similar to how the modern LEGO games worked, but at the time it was very confusing, and all the levels in this game were very short. Like, they're all like 10, they're all like 2 minutes long, some of them. Like, you could get true adventurer status like really fast. So it was kind of crazy. A lot of different style of a LEGO game, and of course it focused on the fourth Indiana Jones movie, which was Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, which a lot of people didn't like. So that probably didn't help it either. So overall, LEGO Indiana Jones 2, The Adventure Continues was not very good. And I think consider the first game to be much better. If you're going to play a LEGO Indiana Jones game, I definitely recommend finding the first game. You can probably find it online somewhere. And it's also backwards compatible on the Xbox. So if you have an Xbox One, you can definitely play that. But now it's 2020, and we're now 11 years away from the last LEGO Indiana Jones game. So we had the one in 2009, and now it's been 11 years. There hasn't really been any Indiana Jones movie, so I guess it kind of makes sense. TT Games usually releases LEGO games based around something new coming out, like a new movie or TV show or something. You know, the Skywalker saga is coming out due to the Skywalker saga ending and episode 9 coming out. And we had LEGO Jurassic World that came out for the Jurassic World movie. Things like that. There hasn't really been anything for Indiana Jones. So it kind of makes perfect sense why we haven't gotten a game. But that is until next year. So in 2021, I believe summer 2021 in July, we're finally going to be getting Indiana Jones 5 with Harrison Ford. He's going to be like a 70-something year old Indiana Jones, which is going to be pretty crazy. I guess it's going to take place in what, like the 70s or something like that? Who knows? But with a new Indiana Jones movie, that brings the potential of a new LEGO Indiana Jones video game. So could we be getting LEGO Indiana Jones 3 next year? What could they call it? LEGO Indiana Jones 3, the complete adventures or something like that? Like, they can't really use saga because that's kind of a Star Wars term. And I guess Marvel's kind of using it now with the Infinity Saga. But so yeah, I would call this game LEGO Indiana Jones 3, the complete adventures. I think that's what I would call this game. And this would include the first movie all the way up to this new fifth movie. Maybe they could focus on the fifth movie a little bit more because that's the new movie and they kind of want to promote it with all the marketing and whatnot. So I think this can make for a really good LEGO game, because if you go back and play the first two games, as I mentioned, they're pretty old now. You know, they follow the formula from the original LEGO Star Wars games, which isn't bad, but LEGO games have evolved and changed a lot over time. Like, the graphics have gotten way better, a lot of the game mechanics have changed, there's been a lot of new mechanics. Like, you know, now the levels are much longer. So Indiana Jones 1 especially, and Indiana Jones 2, where the levels were really short, they follow the shorter levels. Like, the levels maybe take maybe 10-15 minutes in LEGO Indiana Jones 1 and maybe like 5 minutes in Indiana Jones 2. And the newer LEGO games, if you play those, the levels take like 30 minutes or longer. Like, they're a lot longer, a lot more beefy. So I think if they made a new LEGO Indiana Jones, they could make the levels a lot longer and have more explorable areas. And I'm not sure what they would do with the hub world. Maybe they would have separate hub worlds to the different locations visited throughout the movie. I'd like it if they just did Barnett College again, like they did in the first LEGO Indiana Jones game, but just make it way bigger, make it like an open world type of thing. They could have the whole college where you can visit the different buildings in the college and things like that. I think that'd be pretty neat. So yeah, I think they could make the levels a lot longer. I think they could implement save points in the levels, which is a new feature that wasn't implemented in the old LEGO games. And I think they could do a lot more with Indiana Jones's whip. They could probably do different mechanics, make it a little bit more accessible, because in the old LEGO games, when you have an item, like the characters carry like a blaster or something, you couldn't do much with it. They've added new features since then, like you can aim and things like that. So I think they could do a lot more with Indiana Jones and his whip. And of course, the graphics would look way better. I imagine the graphics would look pretty good. This would be a next-gen game. At least it would be cross-gen. It'd probably be on the current consoles and the next-gen consoles. So coming out in 2021. So I think the graphics would look a lot better. You know, Indiana Jones has lots of jungly environments. And the Temple of Doom could look good too from the second movie. And that would really make the graphics look great, because jungle environments, if you look at the indoor level in the Force Awakens game, that level looked great. Because just imagine that, but looking even better on the next-gen consoles for Indiana Jones. I think it would look incredible, especially when you compare it to the first two games, which came out over 10 years ago, back on the previous gen, which, if this game comes out, that'll be two generations ago. So they could really improve the graphics a lot, and I think it'd look really great. So yeah, I think we might be getting LEGO Indiana Jones The Complete Adventures, LEGO Indiana Jones 3 The Complete Adventures next year, maybe late summer or early fall next year, around the release of this new movie coming out in July. And I think it would be a pretty great game. It definitely pleased the Indiana Jones fans and the LEGO Indiana Jones fans, because we have not gotten a game in a long time. And I think it would be a good follow-up to the Skywalker Saga game, and it could even follow, like I mentioned earlier on in the video, exactly what they did with the Complete Saga, where they had the Complete Saga, and then they had Indiana Jones 1. They could do Skywalker Saga, and then this Indiana Jones 3 game, and I think it would just be a good follow-up to the Skywalker Saga game. And maybe they could still do LEGO Marvel as well in 2022, or maybe they could do both. Maybe this Indiana Jones game would be kind of a smaller game, and then the LEGO Marvel game would be the bigger game of 2021 if they want to go back to doing two games per year. Who knows? But anyway, that's going to do it for this video. Be sure to subscribe to be notified right when the newest LEGO video game speculation and news videos come out. We're still waiting on news for the Skywalker Saga, at least at the time we're recording this. Maybe we got news since then. But yeah, that's going to do it for this video. Like the video if you enjoyed it, and comment what you think about LEGO Indiana Jones 3, the possibility of it coming out with the new movie. What things would you like to see in the game? You know, I would just like to see the levels redone with the modern LEGO mechanics. You know, LEGO games have changed a lot. I just want to see them do it now with what they have now and the modern graphics on the next-gen consoles. But anyway, that's going to be it for this video. I'll see you guys next time.